Both candidates share a background and education, but despite that shared experience, they offer very different views on education.
The 57th House race matches up Republican Troy Lawson and Democrat Ashton Clements. Lawson, who currently sits on the board of a local charter school, says he supports school choice and questions traditional public schools.
The schools in this area are failing all over this area. And I think that's a disconnect, whereas on the other side of the district, the west side, the schools are not failing.
Clemens, a former assistant superintendent for the Thomasville schools, says what's failing is the Republican-led legislature and its lack of funding for schools.
We are still not up to the per pupil spending that we had in our state before the recession in 2008.
The cost of expanding Medicaid also divides these two candidates as well. Right now, the federal government covers 90% of the cost, but Republicans say they worry state taxpayers may eventually foot the bill.
What changes politically, we don't know. But either way, it's the right thing to do to cover the people of our state. My commitment to giving health care to people across our state is unwavering.
I don't believe in expanding that program. I think we need to look at, there's a lot of waste and fraud in that program.
Before I let you go on that, because that's an important statement you just made. Any evidence that there's rampant fraud in Medicaid?
I wouldn't say it's rampant. My research says that there is some.
Sure.
Yeah.
The two House candidates have very different views on the Supreme Court nomination hearings of Judge Kavanaugh and the women accusing him of sexual misconduct. Lawson says he opposes an FBI investigation, saying they have, quote, more important things to do.
If Mr. Kavanaugh were guilty of some kind of sexual misconduct back in high school, would that disqualify him in your mind?
Well, that's a loaded question.
I realize it's 35 years ago, but I'm wondering, is that grounds to terminate his nomination in your mind?
I don't know how to answer that, Bill.
Clemens says she wants to hear from the accusers and welcomes a full investigation of their claims.
If you're going to be on our Supreme Court for your lifetime, you're responsible for your past, no matter how far back it goes.
The 57th House leans heavily toward Democrats, who make up 50% of the district. Only 21% of the district is Republican. They're outnumbered by unaffiliated voters, who make up 27% of the district. It's also a district that voted overwhelmingly for Hillary Clinton in 2016. The Democrat captured 65% of the vote.
People say that. I don't feel it. I don't.
For you to lose would be a tremendous upset.
I believe that is true. That's how people feel. That's not how I'm running, though.
You're confident of winning?
Yes, absolutely. Because I have a better message. I have a better message to this community, and I have a better message to my entire district.
Lawson says the Republicans' plan to keep unemployment and taxes low will give him the win on Election Day. Clemens, on the other hand, says it is Democrats who are going to fight for education and health care that will win her the election. In Greensboro, I'm Bill O'Neill, WXII 12 News.